So as I'm recording this, I'm right in the middle of October, or Shirttober 2023, and I'm creating 31 designs for 31 days, and I'm using Kittle to do all of it. So in this video, I want to show you how I created this design right there, this hockey design, and I'm going to show you how I use some of Kittle's new features, like the AI quote generator, the AI image vectorizer, and the AI background remover to make this design on Kittle. I'm going to show you step by step on what I did and how to take a template to create this final version of this hockey design. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step on how I'm using Kittle to create designs for Shirttober. I'm just going to do one design here. I may do other videos in the future, but this design is going to be this hockey design that I made. And I'm going to show you step by step on how to do it. And I want to show you Kittle's new feature, the newest feature being the AI quote generator, which they have now, which is really cool. It gives you some ideas. And so that's how I'm coming up with the sayings on my t-shirt, as well as some new improvements to the AI vectorizer. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Earlier, you were only able to do one color, and now you can do multiple colors. So that's really cool. Let's get into Kittle right now, and I'll show you step by step on how to do this. All right, so here we are on Kittle. First step is to find a template. So since this is a hockey design, I'm just going to type in here, hockey. Boom, and there's only one. So I'm going to use this one. Use this design, very easy. And I want to make this the right size first. So I'm going to come in here in settings. You can see it's made in inches. I'm going to change that to pixels. And I'm going to do 4,500 by 5,400 and confirm. So you can see it was a lot smaller. So I'm just going to grab all of these and stretch it till it fits somewhere around there or so. Yeah, I think that would work. Okay, so I want to change this. So we're going to take some things out. I'm going to take this guy out and use a different one. I'm going to take this out. I'm going to change this to say hockey is my favorite season. Good. I don't think we need 38 here. Let's take this out, 1993. In fact, let's take all of this out. Let's do that and that. We'll keep this. This is kind of cool. Whoops, it's not grouped. Let's group it all. Command G. Good, and I can size it up or down. There. Cool. I want this on a black t-shirt, so let's see what that looks like. Cool. Oh, there's that line in there. So let's double click on there. Let's take that and make it nothing. Yeah, I think that works. Okay, and this guy needs to be a different color. So let's do this white. Cool. So we got a lot to fill in here. So I'm gonna go to photos and I'm gonna type in hockey. And there's a lot to choose from here. I'm gonna do, let's see, scroll down. Want something, yeah, this one. Boom, perfect. I have something back here. I don't need that texture right now, so I'm gonna release texture and just delete that. Okay, now first thing we're gonna do is the AI background remover, and that's gonna help me kind of just isolate this person instead. So I'm gonna do that, click. Boom, so there you go. I just have this. So the next thing I'm gonna do to make it look more vintage and to fit it, I'm gonna do the image vectorizer. I'm gonna click here. Now this is new. Before it only did one color, but now I can do many colors. I'm just gonna do three on here so you can see what it looks like. And I'm gonna hit vectorize image. The nice thing about vectorizing this image is now that I can scale it and make it bigger, I won't have to lose any quality or anything. And you can see it did it right away. I'm gonna scale it up like this. And it works perfect. So somewhere like that. And now I can change this color. So if I want this On lighter, I can make this white. If I want this brighter, I can make this more red. So let's see, you know, like that. And this black one, I could actually even remove it so you can see, well, you can't see me removing it. I'll show you when I change the background color. So if this background color was there, you can see it was removed. But if I can put it back, it will be black, right? So I think I'm gonna leave it black. I think that's fine. Let's make this black again, the background. Great. So next thing we're gonna need is a saying. I already have this right here, but I want something big right here. So we're gonna use the AI quote generator. We're gonna have to go back to Kittle to do that. Luckily, it opened this in a new tab, so I can just go back here and do this AI tool here. This is where the quote generator is. You can see we already used the background remover and the image vectorizer, so we're gonna use this one right here. Now I'm gonna generate quotes. I can type in anything here. You can use any one of these, but I'm gonna just do hockey, since that's what we're doing, and hit continue, and pick a mood. I'm gonna go funny, and we can do short, longer, longer, and even longer words, right? So I'm just gonna do 2 to 4 words, so it's gonna make sure that it's in there. And I think 2 to 4 works really well for t-shirts. Maybe 5 to 8 words, depending how big you want, but 2 to 4, I think, is kind of the nice sweet spot. So I'm gonna generate quotes. It's gonna cost me 1 credit, 1 AI credit, but I got a bunch here, so I'm okay. So you can see here are some ideas. Puck yeah, cool as ice, snapshot champion. The last time I did this, it actually gave me puck life, but it's not doing the same thing here. Obviously, it just generates more different ones. Now you can download this and it will save it as a file so that you can have it for later. Or you could just copy this, use this quote, and then this does, what does this do? Oh, it copied it to the clipboard, that's nice. You can download this, so you can see it saved it as a text file, or you can use this quote, and what that does is it just opens it up into another one with the text there. So I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna copy this, Command C, and go here, Command V. So I'm gonna do that. So let's find a good font for this. I'm gonna copy this and just do yeah down here, and puck up here. Oh, actually, let's do life, puck life, since that's what it was when I did it for my t-shirt here. But we could do anything we want here. I'm gonna show you the typeface that we use. I use this one, 60s, Ekuntia or something. There you go. So another font that I like, I'm gonna move this up here, is Merce Gothic. It's a nice big thick wide font, so let me show you. I'm just gonna do the E for this one so you can see the difference, and move this closer like this, so you can have it distressed, or you can do it like, you know, try different fonts. I like this wide one here, kind of takes up a good space. Same thing with this one. Let's do the P, a different one. So let's try that box. What is it called? Box pop. Yeah, there you go. Make that bigger like that. And then let's use that Merce again for this one. Merce Gothic, all caps. I think it's just a nice wide font to take up some space. Now, in order to match this here, let's go look for a puck. So I'm gonna go to elements and puck. Yeah, we got all of these. I can use this one right here. Let's make sure that it's white. Boom. And lastly, oh, let's make this white too. And lastly, we need some background down out back here to kind of fill in the space. I have a cool one that I liked using, and let's see, I had it bookmarked. So you can bookmark stuff here, my projects, folders, templates. You can see it's bookmarked. I have this one right here, and we're gonna do a new project with this so you can see it. And there's this right here, this background. I'm gonna copy that. So Command C. So now that I copied that, I'm gonna just paste it back here. Command V. And you can see it's a little small, so I'm gonna put it right here. And that's a cool background. I'm gonna change the color to make it sprite, and I can pull it down here so it's lighter. And there you go. Oh, let's do a texture now. Let's go put this texture back on. Grunge texture. Make sure we have the clip content and alpha mask. And if we don't like that one, we can use some of these other ones down here. Halftone would be good. This alpha mask section, I really like using that. We can try out some of these things. You can see it gives it kind of like the distressed look. That's too much. That's probably too much too. That's pretty good. Let's see what else we got down here. That's not bad. Not bad. So I went with this one right here. You can see it's a little distressed. I don't think there's a name here, but that's the one. I'm using Alpha Mask and everything. So there you go. That's how easy it is to do it. Now I can export this thing. Export, download this design, and make sure you remove background, optimize quality, hit PNG, and there you go. So you can see how easy this was to take it from a template and then making it your own with a new photo, which I changed into a vector and some text and some grunge feature and changing it. So it looks very different than the template I started with. And so I feel safe to make this my own and use this on print on demand where nobody else is copying this exactly. I'm gonna have my own thing. So there you go. That's how easy it is to use Kittle using a template, the vectorizer, the new quote generator, and removing the background. Of course, if you got a photo, you can remove the background. So many different things now using AI that makes your designs or helps you make your designs a lot easier. So hopefully that was really helpful for you. Try it out. Try out those different things. I think the quote generator can be really helpful if you get stuck and you're not sure. If you already have a subject like I do with Shirttober, it's really easy to just try that generator. Make sure to check for trademarks. Yeah, I think it comes out with so many different ideas that you can do a different one. I could just change the text in there for another hockey design, maybe change the graphic, and there you go, another one, change the color, and so on. So pretty cool. If you want to see another Kiddo video, I have this one right here. In fact, I have a whole playlist of Kiddo stuff right here. I'll put that for you to watch. You can see all the different styles that Kiddo can do and just have fun with it. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.